she know I'm about to lie. Passing by, right before your eyes, right before your eyes. Say I gotta be grateful. Say I gotta be grateful.
I think what he's trying to say is what I've been seeing.
Come on, twin. We're stronger than that.
He's been singing what I've been trying to say for the longest. And what I know in my heart is that there's nobody else in my life that I want to be with. And at the end of the day, this long race we've been running, I don't want to run with nobody else in my life. I want to get to know you more. I want to push you towards godliness. I want to see you mature as a woman of God the way that God has made you. And the last question that I have for the night is, will you be my wife?
After all of that had happened, and Canon was life flighted, myself, Tom, we drove back to where the rest of the team was. At that point, I was still dealing with the guilt, and I was very apologetic and just kind of holding the blame. But Derek and Doc, they kept assuring me, that it's okay, that it wasn't my fault, and everything's gonna be okay.
The thing I'm thinking is, how are we gonna tell his wife that he just got married to less than a month ago that this dude is at the bottom of a bridge, broken up? So we just sort of waited till we got more information, and then Doc made the call.
So I got the call while I was at my friend's birthday party, and he was telling me that Aaron fell and that he was in an accident and he was being taken to Vanderbilt Hospital in Nashville. I definitely knew I needed to get on the road, so a couple of my friends came out from the party and they were like, you okay? What's going on? And I told them Aaron was in the accident. That's all I could get out. And so they jumped in the car with me. So it was probably the longest drive ever. As soon as we got there, went to the floor where he was on, and I ran into Doc and Brandon and some other guys on his label, and they were all just waiting there in the waiting room, in the trauma center.
So they told us what room to get. They told us where he would be at, but he's in the trauma center. So the trauma center, they don't have rooms. Everyone's pretty much in the same area.
They immediately called the doctor over, the surgeon that was gonna operate on his foot. Doctor is telling me.
First he said, I don't want to minimize what's happened, but he is very, very blessed and lucky to be alive. And the fact that he landed in solid ground, dry, is astronomical in itself, not just even thinking of the fall. He proceeded to tell us that his jaw is going to have to be wired shut. He broke his jaw.
A bruised lung. Shattered his ankle and part of his tibia and fibula on his leg. The surgeries that he would need would be repaired to his jaw, so surgery on his jaw. He'd have to get his mouth wired. He'd have to get a trach tube because they were having issues with intubating him to be able to get air through his throat into his lungs.
So my brain, I'm thinking, oh my gosh, man, what are we gonna do? Like, not what is he gonna do? What are we gonna do? Because as brothers, that's how I am.
I immediately feel overwhelmed. I had just been his wife a couple weeks, so you know, I wasn't prepared to have that type of responsibility. I never had somebody's life in my hand like that, and I needed to either approve with the surgery or, you know, make decisions for him as far as what was gonna happen next.
Audio rewind. Breaking them off that are logical, theological. I'm only giving you truth that are correlate with the Bible. Not some are philosophical, psychological article, but eschatological, biblical truth in the audio. My name is Canon. Holler at me in the back. I love y'all, y'all. Thank y'all for y'all time.
I remember this like yesterday. They're like, Canon's coming up. And it's like, he's coming up if you want to see him. They're gonna roll him out through this elevator to the trauma center.
I remember I saw him, and I was just seeing all the tubes and things and wires and things connected to him, you know. It wasn't a good sight. I was really speechless. I was speechless at that moment.
His face was swollen to where I didn't even recognize him. I didn't even know what he looked like. I was like, this is not him. He didn't even look the same. And I remember just being like, this is serious.
It was hard to see him in that state because he was just had a lot of wires and tubes around him, and he was unconscious, and
it was surreal because you almost don't want to believe it. You know, it's kind of like a little bit of denial. I mean, we talking about our bond was strong, you know, I mean, still is, but that's like my little brother. Like, he literally lived in my basement. I didn't want to believe how traumatic it was because just my own personal fear. And then just to kind of see the realities of it and hear about him in the hospital and the whole nine was really just like, it was heartbreaking, you know, for my whole family. For many, many, many reasons, you know what I'm saying? Newly married. I mean, I just saw it. I mean, it was just so much. It was a real emotional ball of like, what the heck is going on right now?
When I went to see him, I think that's when it all became real as far as, you know, how bad and how serious this really was. Like, nothing would be the same from this day forward, you know? He may recover, you know, physically, you know, and be maybe even stronger than he was before, you know. But as far as his personality, you know, like, you don't go through something like that and be the person you were before it happened.
So I woke up, and again, I couldn't breathe. But I, you know, the first thing I did was I was like, where's my stuff at? Like, where's my stuff at? And you know, the first thing that I began to look at was my hand, like my ring. Cause I was trying to, like, I was so lost. I couldn't remember everything that was going on and everything that I just came from. And so I looked at my ring and I thought, oh, my hand. But my ring wasn't there. Like, all my jewelry was taken off. So I look at my hand, I'm like, where's my ring? My ring. I'm married. Where's my wife? Where's my wife?
I saw him asking for his wife and, you know, trying to, and pointing at his ring finger. And, you know, I tried to, like, run over there and, like, tell him, hey, I'm here, it's okay. And, you know, pointing to his ring finger. And, you know, I think somebody, I don't know if it was a nurse or someone around there was like, oh, that's so sweet, you know, asking for his wife, pointing at his ring finger. And I was like, yeah, nah, y'all don't know him. He's looking for his ring. He wants to look fresh, you know. So I was like, don't worry, I'm gonna go find your stuff. And, it was a moment of relief to know, like, man, he still recognized me. He was alert in some capacity. And it was just, just gave me hope to know that it was gonna be okay.
Seeing his wife, you know, Ritz, do everything to make sure that Canon was good.
I mean, she just exhausted herself serving Canon. It that was one of the most encouraging parts about the whole thing.